Good evening, everyone. Thank you all so much for being here tonight. I know it's a bit of a rush having a 5:30 concert, but again, thank you all for getting here and most importantly, getting all these amazing kids here. You are going to hear a fantastic show. I had the privilege this afternoon, they did a little dress rehearsal for me with some of the kids, not all of them, but it is fantastic. So sit back, relax, make sure those cell phones are off so you can enjoy this concert. And again, thank you for your support to the music program as well. I'm gonna turn things over to Mrs. Evans and our amazing Fairgrave Orchestra. All right, well thank you again, as Ms. Ansel said, for getting here and being ready to see us. I'm hoping that you are as amazed as I have been to see the amount of growth that we've had since our January concert. Usually our concerts are December and we have all the way through until this time to prepare for this week. Our rehearsals were about halved. So to say that I'm impressed is an understatement. Our first piece is Hot Cross Buns.
Thank you. is the traditional Twinkle variations, but with a twist. I found a really great video on YouTube, which brings me to, I had difficulties downloading it from YouTube, so if Grammarly interrupts us, I apologize. It's our favorite ad, right? That and what? VRBO? VRBO, and then lately it's been Google Fi. So those are our three advertisements we see at school often, and if it does pop on, I apologize, but we will start right after. Thank you so much for sharing your children with me. It truly has been a great year. We had, it's a year to remember, right? We all had last year's year to remember, but this one's proving to be just as tough. But they're resilient, and we're still learning. We're still learning, and we are still growing, and for that, we should really, truly be thankful. So we're going to finish out tonight's concert with Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. Thank you.
did you know that every time musicians pick up their instruments, there are fireworks going off all over their brain? On the outside, they may look calm and focused, reading the music and making the precise and practice movements required. But inside their brains, there's a party going on. How do you know this? Well, in the last few decades, neuroscientists have made enormous breakthroughs in understanding how our brains work by monitoring them in real time with instruments like fMRI and PET scanners. When people are hooked up to these machines, tasks such as reading or doing math problems each have corresponding areas of the brain where activity can be observed. But when researchers got the participants to listen to music, they saw fireworks. Multiple areas of their brains were lighting up at once as they processed the sound, took it apart to understand elements like melody and rhythm, and then put it all back together into a unified musical experience. And our brains do all this work in a split second between when we first hear the music and when our foot starts to tap on it. But when scientists turn from observing the brains of music listeners to those of musicians, the little backyard fireworks became a jubilee. It turns out that while listening to music engages the brain in some new interesting activities, playing music is the brain's equivalent of a full-body workout. The neuroscientists saw multiple areas of the brain light up, simultaneously processing different information in intricate, interrelated, and astonishingly fast sequences. But what is it about making music that sets the brain alight? The research is still fairly new, but neuroscientists have a pretty good idea. Playing a musical instrument engages practically every area of the brain at once, especially the visual, auditory, and motor cortices. And as with any other workout, disciplined, structured practice in playing music strengthens those brain functions, allowing us to apply that strength to other activities. The most obvious difference between listening to music and playing it is that the latter requires fine motor skills, which are controlled in both hemispheres of the brain. It also combines the linguistic and mathematical precision in which the left hemisphere is more involved with the novel and creative content that the right excels at. For these reasons, playing music has been found to increase the volume and activity in the brain's corpus callosum, the bridge between the two hemispheres, allowing messages to get across the brain faster and through more diverse modes. This may allow musicians to solve problems more effectively in both academic and social settings. Because making music also involves crafting and understanding its emotional content and message, musicians often have activities of executive function, a catalog of intricate tasks that includes planning, strategizing, and attention to detail, and requires simultaneous analysis of both cognitive and emotional aspects. This ability also has an impact on how our memory systems work. And indeed, musicians exhibit enhanced memory functions, creating, storing, and retrieving memories more quickly and efficiently. Studies have found that musicians appear to use their highly connected brains to give intimately of multiple tags, such as a conceptual tag, emotional tag, an audio tag, and a contextual tag, and can hear unique search results. So how do you know that all these benefits are unique to music, as opposed to, say, sports or painting? Or could it be that people who go into music are better ones starting to be aware? Neuroscientists have explored these issues, but so far they have found that the artistic and aesthetic aspects of learning to play a musical instrument are different from any other activity setting, including by arts. In several randomized studies of participants who showed the same levels of cognitive function and neuroplasticity at the start, found that those who were exposed to a copy of music learning showed a basement in multiple brain areas compared to others. This recent research about the mental benefits of playing music has advanced our understanding of mental function, revealing the different rhythms in the impacts of the brain that make up the major brain structure of the brain.
Our Fairgrave Music in Our Schools Month concert. Next up, we have our band.
portion of tonight's concert. We're going to kick off our portion with a pep band themed performance. Right on these chorus risers, we have our Fairgrave percussion ensemble. I'm going to play a percussion cadence called Zombie Squirrels.
Let's go, Bear!
cheer up on the screens to talk about our mascot. This cheer is Let's Go Falcons!
Incredible.
Next up, announcements. One, I forgot to recognize another special person up here. This is our sixth grade teacher, Miss Stahl. Miss Stahl is actually the best example of what we really want as a music department, lifelong musicians. It's really our goal for these kids up here to play from fifth grade all the way to 12th grade, all the way to in college and pep bands at those sports games, or even community bands in the area. And then maybe if they become a teacher, they'll come play in school band. All right, so we're gonna transition to our amazing third grade chorus. You can watch some really interesting video on the benefits of performing and learning an instrument while we transition over. Thank you again.
Our parents are the best for their children. But are your child's extracurricular activities having a lasting impact or hoping for one? Maybe it's time to consider music for your child. Music education during childhood has been shown to have a multitude of benefits. It sharpens students' attentiveness, abstract reasoning, and creativity. Children who are musically trained have stronger everyday listening and memory skills. In addition, music engages both sides of the brain and challenges children to simultaneously concentrate on multiple tasks. Music and math are highly intertwined. By understanding beats, rhythm, and scales, even the youngest music makers are learning how to divide, create fractions, and recognize patterns. Music also helps children develop coordination and motor skills, as well as self-discipline and self-esteem. Students who participate in music programs consistently score higher in mathematics and English than their peers. Studies have also shown that individuals who took music lessons as children often show stronger neural processing of sound, even up to 50 years later. Making the decision to enroll your child in music class is a no-brainer. Parents, build your child's cognitive and emotional development and give them the gift of music. To learn more about the benefits of making music at every stage of life, visit NAMFoundation.org.
Thank you so much for your patience. It's our first time on risers ever, so we're trying to make it work. We practiced on stairs today, but it's not the same. So thank you for your patience. All right, this is our fifth and sixth grade chorus, and we have two pieces for you today, and we're thinking of songs that are like inspirational and hopeful. So our first one is Home, originally performed by Philip Fell.